Wee daddy, even the clock keeps ticking. Daddy, won't you please come home?
Guys, good to see you. So today, I've been working on something really interesting. Oh, Woodrow, poor guy. Oh, come here. Oh, let me dust you off. Yeah, oh, I know you're so upset. Ugh, sorry, guys. Stop eating insulation. Get out of there. So today, somebody came into the museum and donated something really special.
What's the big deal? It's just a baseball.
It's not just a baseball, Woodrow. This baseball was signed by someone really important. Someone who changed history and is a hero for many people today.
Chef Boyardee?
No, Woodrow. This ball was signed by Jackie Robinson. You may have heard of him before, or maybe you know something about his story. He was born just around 100 years ago, when life in America was very difficult for African Americans. They lived in Georgia, in the heart of the South. His dad left after Jackie was born, so his mother moved them to California and raised all five kids by herself. Things were hard for Jackie growing up, but his two older brothers were an inspiration to him. They loved sports and tried to share that love with Jackie. His brother Mac even went to the Olympics and won a silver medal. Watching them, Jackie decided to go to high school, then college, to follow his sports dreams. Now, for him, it wasn't just baseball. He played football, basketball, and ran track, and was good at all of them. But just when he graduated and began to play football professionally, history happened. This was the beginning of a terrible conflict that we call World War II. There had been another war just 20 years before, and this time, America wasn't taking any chances. Jackie Robinson, along with thousands of other young men, were drafted. A draft is when a country forces people to join the army and become soldiers. Instead of letting this get him down, Jackie worked even harder and soon became an army officer in charge of a group of other soldiers. But his career wouldn't last long, even though he'd become a very important soldier. One day he was riding on a bus and was asked to give up his seat just because of the color of his skin. Jackie said no. He was arrested and later released from the army. Even though that awful thing happened, it might have saved Jackie's life. You see, right after the arrest, a group of soldiers went to Europe to fight his group of soldiers, and a lot of them died. History can move in mysterious ways, and for Jackie, it set him up to become a legend. Woodrow, once you dusted yourself off, could you start the film?
Coming right up!
Not long after that, Jackie got a letter offering him a contract to play baseball in the Negro Leagues. A contract meant that he would be paid money to play, that he would be a professional athlete. He accepted. Now, professional baseball at the time was divided into two groups, Major League Baseball for white players and the Negro Leagues for African American players. Each group had its own stars, teams, and stadiums. A lot of players and coaches thought that was the way it should stay, but there were a few that disagreed. A man named Branch Rickey was the president of the Brooklyn Dodgers baseball team, which was all white. He wanted to be the first team to put an African American onto the field and to try to break what was called the color barrier that kept the two different leagues apart. After seeing Jackie play, he asked him to sign a contract with the Brooklyn Dodgers, but only if he would be able to take the angry racist threats from people who wanted to keep the leagues separate. Jackie, angry, asked him,
Mr. Rickey, do you want a ball player who's afraid to fight back?
I want a ball player with guts enough not to fight back.
What he wanted was a talented player who could turn the other cheek and not let people's angry words get him riled up. Jackie was the right man for the job. Over his whole career, Jackie faced horrible problems. He wasn't allowed to stay in the same hotel as the rest of the team. Opposing players trash-talked him from the dugouts. He was even injured in rough plays. But the more that people bullied him and tried to scare him, the more his teammates supported him and fans came to watch him play. and he was good. Really good. He was an All-Star 6 times, won a World Series with the Dodgers in 1955, even starred in a movie about himself, which inspired more kids to follow their sports dreams. When he was an old man, Jackie asked people not to remember him for breaking the color barrier, but to remember him for how well he played and how dedicated he was to the game of baseball. That's how I like to think of him. Next time you go to a Major League Baseball game, look for his number, 42. You'll see it in every stadium in the country. Well, that's it for now. Stop by anytime and I'll have something else to show you. Woodrow and I are going to go unclog some toilets.